The next piece I'm playing is actually also of an Irish connotation, but it's a piece that, as euphonium players, you should really know. It was a theme and variations made famous and originally composed by Simon Mantia, the godfather of euphoniums. For those of you that don't know about Simon Mantia, he was around in the early part of the last century, and he was doing all the tricks on the euphonium back then that modern-day euphonium players get plaudits for today. He was doing five-octave stunts, all kinds of acrobatics on the instrument. But as well as being the euphonium player with the Sousa Band, he was also the principal trombonist with the New York Metropole Opera as well. So he was a very talented individual. But this particular theme and variations made its way over to the UK in the 70s, I believe. And the guy that brought it over actually wrote his own name on the music, Mr. Stanley Boddington. So everyone back home thinks that this particular version is by Stanley Boddington. I know otherwise, and I'm delighted to be playing it for you this evening. We do actually have a new arrangement though. I work a lot with a pianist back home in the UK called Chris Williams, and he got tired of playing the same kind of umchucks, if you like, in the piano part for accompaniments for theme variations. So he decided to make up some of his own interludes. So it's quite tricky, but Carol's doing a fantastic job. So we're going to leave you with our final piece, Endearing in Charms by Simon Mantia. Before I play it, thank you very much for being a lovely audience, and thanks also for your hospitality. Everyone I've seen has said hello, and I look forward to getting to know you all a little bit better tomorrow during the masterclass as well. So, Endearing Young Charms.